These are the world's first all-electric passenger ferries. So what are these men doing? Take a guess.
They're about to charge it?
I was talking to the audience, but yes, Dusty, that's right. This is one of Oslo's all-electric ferries, and it only takes 6 minutes to charge the battery for this ship's 60-minute round trip. What you're about to see is the complicated way these ferries get charged. Yeah, I was surprised too. That's it. How freaking simple is that? We are in Oslo to explore how they are electrifying essentially all of their transportation.
Look at that crazy dude. He's skiing on asphalt. Holy I've never seen that before.
Oslo is electrifying essentially everything. Trams, buses, cars, ferries, bikes, scooters. And they're doing this because they have some of the most audacious climate emissions cut goals in the world. Like, for real. By 2030, Oslo's climate budget calls for a nearly 100% reduction in greenhouse gas emissions compared to 2009 levels. These targets actually put Oslo in line with the 1.5 degrees Celsius target set by the Paris Agreement. Norway is seen as one of the most sustainable places in the world. Yet paradoxically, its largest industry is oil and gas, and it's made them incredibly rich. But more on that later. Oslo's government is investing heavily in key sectors they think can help them reach their emissions goals. The construction and transportation sectors together account for 67% of emissions in Oslo. So we came here to see how they're electrifying everything from construction sites down to scooters. Norway has the most electric vehicles of any country in the world. So we're gonna call an Uber to take us to our filming site today and we're gonna see if it's electric.
Maybe we'll get the electric car.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I got one too. Yeah, it's gonna take a little while to get here. We headed out from our hotel to visit our first location, a construction site.
Nice to meet you, Jason.
Henrik,
how you doing?
We wanted to see the machines, tools, and methods that Oslo was using to make the transition towards clean construction. Oslo has mandated that by 2025, all municipal construction sites have to be zero emission. This construction site is already fully electric. Even the vehicles that bring the workers in and out are electric vehicles. With construction alone responsible for 20% of emissions, Oslo began paying more for municipal construction projects to help incentivize the creation of an electric construction equipment industry.
We're ready for you to show us around the site.
Yeah.
This All is right. Kai Vegard Ostnes.
Okay, yep.
I am really sorry, Kai.
Yeah, that was good, huh? That was some good Norwegian.
Hoppers.
This way. So this is an excavator. And this is fully electric?
This is electric, yes.
It is noticeably quieter.
This is the power core for the excavator. This has approximately 50 meters of cable.
Okay.
That's automatically goes in and out. You can see inside here.
Oh, wow.
This is the control unit.
So this itself, this is not a battery. This is connecting
this, is not
this
a battery.
To the power grid.
Yes.
That's very cool.
This is why I love my job.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Can I ask you a question? What's the difference for you in operating this versus a gas-powered one?
Technically, no difference, but just have this cable you need to be careful with.
Is it a pain in the ass being connected?
Okay. So what is this machine?
That's a compactor to make ground solid.
So this is electric?
This is electric.
This is yes. Electric.
This one we have built ourselves because there's no one in the market that can provide you with it.
So with all of these devices that are plugged into their grid, what happens if there's a power outage?
Long lunch break.
Long lunch break. We just learned that all the public parks in Oslo are serviced by electric trucks to pick up trash, and that's what this is. Is this big truck electric?
This is electric. You want to film while he's tipping?
Yeah, that'd be great.
And this is a battery-powered one.
Battery-powered wheeled excavator. This one's operating totally alone. Yeah, we charge during lunchtime. And we can also detach the batteries and replace them.
What you're about to see is...
Oh, I'll switch.
That was it?
Yes.
That was the battery switch?
Yes. This is empty, and now I'll switch to this. It's full.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not complicated.
So what is this guy doing?
Oh, he's going to charge during lunch break.
Fully charged in 60 minutes with the fast charger. But the excavator only needs 30 to 40 minutes of charging at lunch to get through the remainder of the day. If it's being used for light work only, the excavator doesn't even need to be charged at lunch.
That's it?
That's it.
So this excavator is battery powered. This charger is a standard charger that can charge a car. Kai told us that you could pull this into a gas station in Norway and plug it into a normal charger and you could charge it.
Norway now exports electric construction equipment to other countries. And Oslo is ahead of its 2025 goal to make all city construction sites emissions free. While the city of Oslo is making great progress towards its emissions goals, the country, well, not so much.
My name is Sigrun Aasland. I am the director of Zero, Zero Emission Resource Organization in Norway. What we do is promote solutions to the climate crisis, really. Norway has a history in climate policies of setting many goals over many years and not achieving them. I think in Oslo, what's made it possible is that Oslo has this climate budget where they actually commit politicians to cutting emissions.
Believed to be the first of its kind, the climate budget integrates decision-making about emissions alongside financial budgeting, elevating the practical importance of addressing climate change.
Oslo implemented its climate budget in 2016, and it's not a very complex and complicated instrument. We need to count CO2 as we count money, so there is a budget that you cannot exceed. It makes politicians accountable to actually keep to it.
We called another car via Uber, and we're going to see if it's electric. Looks like it is a Prius, and it is Prius hybrid, so half.
Road transportation accounts for nearly 50% of Oslo emissions, with the single biggest contributor being, you guessed it, scooters.
I almost hit that girl. I almost hit that girl.
No, no, not scooters. Cars. Cars. So we decided to rent an electric car to explore. I'll let Dusty tell you.
So Dusty, what are we doing today?
Oh yeah, I'm not really sure actually. I think we're just getting in this car and going for a joyride, right?
I mean, yeah, neither of us had driven a Tesla before, so free think credit card.
Oh my God, how does this work?
Get in the car.
Hi crew.
Hello.
I don't know if it's on. I don't know where the keys are. And I haven't owned a car since I was 16, so this will be interesting.
So scary.
What could possibly go wrong?
I will say Norwegians are horrible drivers, and there's a lot of traffic accidents, so...
Okay, just hit the gas pedal.
By 2025, all new cars sold in Norway must be zero emission. The country is already known for having the most electric vehicles in the world. But that didn't happen by chance. Government policy going back to the 1990s, well ahead of the rest of the world, has incentivized the purchase and use of EVs through lower taxes, free parking and charging, emission-free car zones, and ring tolls that penalize drivers of petrol cars, or gas cars, for my fellow American cowboys out there.
We're at a busy intersection in Norway, the electric vehicle capital of the world, and we're gonna see how many electric cars we can call out as they pass.
I'm going by the rule of thumb that if it doesn't have a tailpipe, it's electric. No, gas. That was gas.
This is gas.
I'm gonna say gas, gas, gas. You think that Jeep is gas? This intersection is undermining our whole story here. We got a Tesla. That looks electric. If it's futuristic, I'm gonna say it's electric. That's electric.
There's still a decent amount of gas cars, but you know, I don't know, anywhere else in the world, can you stand on the corner and see this many electric cars? I think that's probably the point, right? They still have the most, even if not every car is electric.
This is the best-selling Norwegian vehicle of all time. The only electric vehicle currently manufactured in Norway. This is the Packster. I mean, It's basically a golf cart, right?
I'm not an expert on golf cars.
Well, me neither. This is Catherine Lund. She works at the company that makes this kind of golf cart, the Packster.
We developed the Packster together with Norwegian Post. So they needed a vehicle that was green, of course, ergonomic, efficient in their daily delivery.
Norwegian Posties enter and exit their vehicle over 700 times a day when delivering the mail. That's why the Packster doesn't have doors, even though Oslo winters are pretty cold. Over 3,500 Packsters are in use across Europe, and not just to deliver all that wonderful junk mail.
Food delivery companies, bakeries, public sectors, e-scooter companies like Bolt. It's fun to drive.
The Packster right here, it's a vehicle that we use on our daily operations to help change the batteries on the scooters and the bicycles.
Using two Packsters and a couple electric vans, Bolt replaces the batteries on their entire fleet of vehicles across Oslo every 2 days.
It's a much more efficient vehicle. It's more versatile as to where you can park, and I don't know if this should be on camera or not, but you can also cut the lines on the bike lanes and so on. Very simple to slide them in and slide them out and then replace them on our vehicles.
The Packster can carry a half day's load of batteries, which are then swapped out at lunchtime. The Packster's battery lasts for an 8-hour shift before being fully charged in 6 to 8 hours overnight via existing charging infrastructure.
This has a much smaller battery, but still gives us more than 100 kilometers range.
Awesome. Well, could I maybe give it a drive?
Yeah, of course, definitely.
Okay, I'm gonna get seatbelted in. Do you seatbelt yourself in when you drive?
Of course I do.
Of course you do, but do you really?
Yeah.
Yeah, but do you really?
Yeah. Don't be scared of using the whole accelerator, it's kind of fast.
Don't be scared of using the whole accelerator. Okay, here we go.
As a last mile delivery or service vehicle in urban spaces, the Packster seems like a decent solution. Maybe it's nothing more than a golf cart. But it got me thinking, maybe reducing emissions through electrification isn't just about remaking the buses, cars, trams, and ferries we already have. Maybe it also means we need to invent new, in-between options customized to different needs. And if they're fun to drive, that doesn't hurt either.
We're here in Oslo exploring electric transportation. I'm gonna get dizzy if I keep doing that.
Yeah, okay, we're good.
So I've been trying to find an electric scooter, and the three that are within walking distance are all dead. All the batteries are dead.
There's one.
That one's not dead.
Almost all of Oslo's public mass transit, from trains to trams to buses, is already electric. And by the end of 2023, an additional 450 electric buses will replace the remaining diesel-fueled ones currently on the roads. This will make Oslo the first capital city in the world with an all-electric public transport system. Designed in Norway and built in Turkey, these are the first all-electric passenger ferries in the world. And they're whisper quiet.
So that's the water making noise, but the engines, not very loud.
Those engines are being powered by 1,017 kilowatt hours of batteries on board. And this is the battery that powers the ferry, the ferry operator. A 6-minute, 2,000 kilowatt supercharge gives the ship all it needs for a 60-minute round trip. A ferry could operate for 3 hours straight without recharging and has backup generators just in case. Batteries on board mean the risk of fire, but what's wild is that a battery fire can't actually be extinguished by the crew. All they can do is cool the batteries with a water mist system and contain the fire long enough to evacuate passengers. It takes the fire department and their special equipment to put out the blaze.
On a national level, Norway is a country with many small fjords and many ferries all across the country that have now since 2014 been very rapidly electrified. And that has happened much faster than anyone thought was possible just a few years ago.
I'm determined to take as many modes of electric transportation as possible while in Norway. So next up is the tram.
How How do the people of Oslo feel about this electrification? Well, Oslovians, Osloites, one inhabitant of Oslo told us that people don't generally notice as long as the train or tram they need each day shows up when they need it.
This sign essentially saying, give your car a rest and choose to be green and ride public transit.
Our experience with public transport was that it was clean, frequent, busy but not overcrowded, and one app for purchasing fares made it simple and easy to use. And maybe when it comes to cutting emissions in the transportation sector, these quality of life issues are actually quite vital, because it makes sense to me that someone is more likely to leave their car parked at home and to take the bus, not because it's electric, but because it's safe, affordable, and reliable.
Dude, we rode a tram for like, what, 10 minutes? And we're like in the mountains now. The city just disappeared. We climbed up this hill and then we're like on the foggy hillside now. Crazy.
We've arrived at the contradiction at the heart of this story. Even though Norway is powered almost entirely by clean, abundant hydropower, the country sells over 2 million barrels of oil a day for the rest of the world to burn into the atmosphere. Profits from that oil enables their aggressive climate response.
While Norwegian electricity is very clean, oil and gas is still a large source of emissions on a national budget because of the production phase of the oil.
Yeah, tell me a little about that. As I understand it, oil and gas is the biggest industry in Norway.
It's the biggest industry. It's also a large revenue for government finances, of course.
Thanks to oil profits, Norway owns about 1% of all listed global stocks. That's over $200,000 for each one of the 5 million Norwegian citizens. Instead of ramping down oil production in the immediate future, Norway is trying to make their oil extraction business run on clean wind power.
A lot of people have their jobs related to the oil sector. A lot of qualified personnel, a lot of capital, a lot of expertise and workforces that many people argue we could now use building new green industries.
Norway exports oil, but uses clean power domestically. Is that hypocritical, or is it a clever use of the power of oil profits in service of a sustainable transition?
The main concern in the environmental movement, of course, now is that we take all those resources and those people and that capital, and we make sure that we use that in building green industries on the back of oil and gas.
The fight against climate change requires new, innovative approaches. We aim at least to triple our funding for climate adaptation and resilience.
As we've seen, there are a number of reasons electrification makes sense for Oslo as their path to a cleaner future. And that path might not make sense for other cities with their own unique circumstances. But Oslo can be seen as a case study, a role model even, for how a city can leverage its built-in advantages and get truly aggressive about addressing climate change, even when its own country isn't moving as deliberately. But recently, Norway actually followed the city of Oslo's lead in adopting its own national climate budget. Cities can lead countries, and cities can be inspirations to each other. What innovations are just waiting to be unleashed in cities across Europe, Asia, Africa, and the Americas that efforts like Oslo's can inspire? The electrification of Oslo could maybe be the kindling that lights the fire of urban climate action worldwide.
I don't know if Dusty's gonna come back to work.
The turning radius is pretty impressive.
Our sound guy can't get out of the way fast enough.